My name is Thomas Kail, and I am the director of When I Come to Die. You should expect the most thrilling night of your life in the theater. The play is about a man on death row who survives a lethal injection and then spends the rest of his time trying to figure out how to make best use of what he's been given. What I love about working at Lincoln Center is the trust that's given to the artist. They know that you need to go into a room and make something, and they make it very clear that if there's anything required, walk out the door, yell down the hallway, and it'll be there. But it's also nice to be left alone to go and do your work, because frankly, it's a place that understands process and understands that, you know, the first week will be this, the second week that, and on and on. And so you get a chance to really sink in, feel safe and comfortable to go and make what you need to do. One of the nice things about directing a five-person play, for instance, is the room is small, and you can, you know, attach to the work and attach to each other very quickly. You know, we're all there for the same reason. And whether you have 27 people on stage or 23 or 5, you know, my job is to make the room feel safe so everybody can come in and do their work. So there's not a huge difference in working on a big musical and a play in that respect, because my responsibility is the same. It just sometimes can be facilitated a little more readily and quickly when you have a small group, because we're all in there every day, you know, going after it. With a musical, you split rooms, there's music in one room, you know, you're staging a scene in the other room, then there's dance in the third room. And it's not until, you know, the second and third week when all the elements start to come together, whereas with a play, we're all in there from the very beginning. And from day one on, you're just kind of cranking together. Nathan and I forged a really lovely relationship on Brokeology, and I realized that he had given us a gift and he'd given us this blueprint, and our job was to go and build this house based on, you know, what he had put down on that page. He's a wonderful collaborator in that he listens, he's smart, he's performed, he's directed, so he knows his way around all the different departments, and that certainly makes it easy as you're trying to evolve something and push it to whatever its next level or next form is, because he understands that it's not just, I wrote it, make it happen. He understands what it means for a group of people to try to bring that to life. So it's a very easy collaboration, and it's just fun to be back in the room with him. I certainly hope this is, you know, another chapter in my story with Nathan, and it's certainly one that we've had a lot of fun, you know, in these first two iterations with Brokeology, and now getting a chance to do a brand new show, you know, and try to bring that together in really the ideal circumstance, which is working here at Lincoln Center. I hope that I can fool him enough that he will trust me with another one of his plays. Yes.